Hey there, welcome back to our Power Platform tutorial series. I'm Tiyani. Today we'll explore on how to leverage virtual tables with SharePoint lists for a seamless integration with Power Platform, tapping into the CRUD operation capabilities of Dataverse for app development. Before we dive into this exciting adventure, do me a solid, hit that subscribe button, give us a surrounding thumbs up, and let your thoughts pour down in the comment section below. Your support is greatly appreciated. Let's get started. In our SharePoint environment, we have a site with a list for managing school soccer teams. This list contains records of our players, details along with their parents. The school already manages this data in SharePoint, but the D365 users want visibility of this data and be able to update and add new players without creating a physical table in Dataverse, as that will reinvent the wheel. This is where virtual tables come in handy. Go to our solution in Power Platform, click New, Table, then Table from External Data. In the pop-up dialog, you will see a couple of connections. If you don't have any, you can click Add Connection to add one of your own. For this part of the tutorial, we'll use one of the existing SharePoint connections I have. Click Next. Here you will see all sites available for the selected connection. If you have already used some, type in the URL for your SharePoint and click Next. This will list all available lists in that selected site. Select the appropriate one. In our case, it's the soccer team. And make sure to check the checkbox under the list to be able to configure the table and column names from our source. Then click Next button. This will take us to the mappings pane, giving us the opportunity to map the source table to the destination virtual table. Go ahead and map them accordingly, and even change the names if required. I'm just going to change the names to be the same or similar to our source, making sure that I keep the naming scheme consistent. When done, click Next. Review your configurations, and when satisfied, click Finish to start the process. Great, our virtual table is done creating. You can go to the tables to review and check if all is okay. You will notice the table type is virtual. And you can see a preview of the data coming from the SharePoint list. Let's add the new virtual table to our app and customize the form a bit so we can start interacting with the data. We are going to add it to our demo model-driven app. You will notice that by adding the virtual table, it added the data source and a connection reference to our SharePoint list. Let's go ahead and customize the sitemap of our model-driven app to add the soccer team page. Let's add a page of our table under the Customers area. Then add, and there, our sitemap page is added. Don't forget to save and publish. Let's see how it looks in our app. Navigate to the soccer team. See our data is there. We can add a new record. Populate the player's name, save. This will take a couple of seconds, longer than normal, as this is writing this to the SharePoint list and not in our app's database. There, our record is saved. We can see it in the app view. Let's go back to SharePoint and see the changes to our data. Scroll all the way down, not there, no worries. Let's refresh the view. And there's our data entry. We can update it like we've done before in SharePoint. These changes we're making will show up in our Power Platform app. I'm just going to add the other columns in our virtual table main form so we can see the data changes we've added to the other columns. We're just going to add all of them. Save and publish. Go back to our app to see the changes. Let's open the same record we updated in SharePoint. And as you can see, our data changes are there. we can make changes vice versa from either system. And there you have it. We took you through a step-by-step process on how to create a virtual table in Power Platform using a SharePoint list, using Power Platform virtual tables with SQL Server databases. Let's get started. As you can see in SQL Server, we have a database called DemoDB, and this table has a couple of records. Our case is that they want to see this data in a model-driven app and be able to perform CRUD operations using a nice user interface for our rugby team. The database is also on-prem. In our solutions, let's add a new table. Then table from external data. And add a new SQL Server connection. Select the authentication type. For this demo, I'm going to be using SQL authentication. Scroll all the way down to choose the gateway. You will notice there is no gateway present. Click New On-Premises Data Gateway to download the gateway software. This software will enable our on-prem database to be available in our Power Platform environment once we are done configuring the gateway. Once the download is done, run the installation process. Accept the terms and conditions and click Install. Grab a cup of coffee while it's installing on the host machine. Once done installing, put in the email address you used to access your Power Platform environment and click Sign In. Select Register a new gateway and click Next. This is an important page. Give your gateway a name. Leave the cluster checkbox empty. Type in the recovery key and keep it saved somewhere safe. Here's the important part. Make sure you choose the correct region where your Power Platform environment is located, or else it won't show up in Power Platform. Then click Done. Click Configure. Once it's done, you should see green ticks stating that your gateway is ready to be used. Next to Power Apps, Power Automate, it should say Ready. And that's it for the gateway setup. Go ahead and check out other settings for your gateway. And once done, close this window. Now when we go back to the Power Platform portal, we can see our gateway is now appearing in the list. Select it and populate the other connection details to our database. Server name, DB name, and the credentials. Then click Create. Give it a second to complete this process. Great, it's now done. And we can see our connection in our list. Back to our solution. Let's continue with the virtual table creation. New, table, table from external data. In the connection list, we can see our newly created SQL Server connection. Select it and click Next. In this stage, let's select the database table from SQL in the list below and make sure to check configure table and column names that will be used in Dataverse and click Next. In this stage, we will have a chance to map and change column names for our virtual table. Once done with mapping columns, click Next and then click Finish. Grab a coffee, this might take a while. Cool stuff, and it's done. And we can see the SQL data in Dataverse. You can go ahead and add the virtual table in a model-driven app and customize the forms. Let's go to our app and navigate to our rugby team table page. The data is there as displayed in SQL Server. Let's delete this record. And as you can see, it's gone. Let's add a new record. Populate the data columns. And save. It's busy saving our data to the SQL database table. And it's now saved. Let's check it out in SQL Server. Let's run the same select statement we ran before. And there's the new record added from the Power Platform model-driven app. The Fiji record we added is now there. And there you have it. In today's tutorial, we took you through a step-by-step guide on creating a virtual table in Power Platform using a SQL Server database table. If you found this tutorial as exciting as we did, give us a virtual high five, hit that like button, and hey, if you're hungry for more thrilling content, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for tuning in.